Hello and welcome to news from Bahrain International. I'm Sarah Bulfat. Upon a statement issued by the Government Executive Committee, His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa has expressed condolences for all COVID-19 victims and their families. His Majesty also expressed his wish for a full and rapid recovery for all those receiving treatment. His Majesty affirmed the importance of solidarity during this ordeal that is spreading across the world. He reassured the citizens that the kingdom will overcome this pandemic and that the state is providing all its resources to Team Bahrain, led by His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister, to overcome the repercussions of the pandemic and ensure the security and safety of the community. He commended the extensive efforts of all healthcare and administrative workers for protecting the community and alleviating the repercussions of the pandemic. The Deputy Prime Minister, His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Mubarak Al Khalifa, had chaired the 382nd Executive Committee meeting held today in the presence of the committee's members. He affirmed that the coronavirus pandemic, like all challenges, calls for renewed commitment to be overcome. He stated that the kingdom is undergoing a critical phase in dealing with the virus, which calls for commitment to all precautionary measures issued by the National Medical Task Force to combat the coronavirus. His Highness stated that the safety of citizens and residents is a top priority according to the vision and aspirations of His Majesty the King. He also noted the importance of maintaining the level of readiness across all sectors to adopt all the measures that would maintain the health of the community according to the directives of His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister. The Deputy Premier affirmed the importance of community awareness, which was key in maintaining safe infection rates. He called on all citizens and residents to strictly adhere to all precautionary measures and take the initiative of signing up for the vaccine and booster dose so as not to jeopardize the safety of the community. He also emphasized the need to continue to demonstrate national and personal responsibility in order to overcome this phase successfully and support the medical task force and frontline workers who are exerting exceptional efforts to maintain the safety of the kingdom. According to a presentation given by the National Medical Task Force to combat the coronavirus, led by its president and chairman of the Supreme Council for Health, Lieutenant General Dr. Sheikh Mohammed bin Abdullah Al Khalifa, the following was decided. To expand the capacity of daily vaccinations, to increase the use of rapid COVID-19 tests as a tool to identify existing cases, update precautionary protocols for existing cases and those in contact with active cases, closing all non-essential sectors and activities starting from the 23:59 on Tuesday, 27th of May 2021 to 23:59 on Thursday, 10th of June 2021 as follows. The closure of all non-essential commercial activities, the prohibition of sports activities, in-person learning to be halted across schools, educational and training institutions, public sector to allow 70% of employees to work remotely, and the prohibition of private gatherings with the continuation of work in essential sectors. The committee concluded by reiterating the importance of following all measures to ensure national efforts against COVID-19 are supported. As part of his visit to the United Kingdom, the Minister of Interior, General Sheikh Rashid bin Abdullah Al Khalifa, met with the Home Secretary of the United Kingdom, Priti Patel, in the presence of the Ambassador of the Kingdom to the UK, Sheikh Fawaz bin Mohammed Al Khalifa. The UK Home Secretary welcomed the visit of the Interior Minister, affirming its importance in bolstering bilateral relations. For his part, the Interior Minister praised the deep-rooted, long-standing partnership between Bahrain and the UK, particularly in the field of police work and criminal justice. He noted the importance of bolstering cooperation with regard to exchanging expertise and capacity building in relation to the application of the experiences of open prisons, the expansion of the application of the alternative penal law, and the development of the current cooperation with the University of Huddersfield to include a doctoral program in human rights. The minister emphasized the solidarity with the efforts to combat terrorism through cooperation with the UK and other friendly the countries and raising the readiness with which to combat it in light of the utilization of modern technologies by terrorist organizations. He also commended the UK's decision in January to classify the Lebanese Hezbollah as a terrorist organization. The Interior Minister reviewed the Kingdom's efforts to combat the coronavirus, which imposed major challenges in all fields, including security and law enforcement. He highlighted the Interior Ministry's participation in Team Bahrain to ensure public safety and the application of preventative and social distancing measures. He expressed his appreciation to the government of the UK for its continuous support to ensure the movement of travel between the two countries despite these circumstances. During the meeting, several topics on security affairs of common interest were discussed, as well as the regional developments within the framework of enhancing security, cooperation and coordination to counter security challenges both regionally and internationally. UK Home Secretary Patel expressed the UK's readiness to bolster security cooperation and coordination, as well as the exchange of expertise with Bahrain to keep pace with current and future developments, contribute to expanding the horizons of joint action and increase the effectiveness of the security services in facing challenges. The national vaccination campaign continues to witness a wide turnout of citizens and residents. The Ministry of Health announced that 888,488 had taken the first dose of the vaccine, while 732,710 had taken the second. The Ministry renewed its call for the community to commit to all precautionary measures and take the initiative to register for the coronavirus vaccination. The Ministry of Health said today that the number of active coronavirus cases reached 24,519, with 1,535 recoveries, 2,766 registered new cases and 21 deaths. 1,071 of the new registered cases are expatriates, 1,679 are contact of active cases, and 16 are travel-related. The Ministry expresses its heartfelt condolences to the families of the deceased and urges everyone to comply with the guidelines issued by the National Task Force for Combating the Coronavirus.